Sneha Adhyapanam is still the first year. The child may not understand your language. By your Sneha, by your love and affection, you have to mix the essence of knowledge or whatever you want to instill inside the child with your love and affection. If you are sending the children to fun school and play school, or sending them to caretakers, and if you are working somewhere else, how you can do something? Second thing is bhava. From the first year to the person's third year, it is by bhava, by expressions and emotional contact with the child. Sneha is biological, and it is an internal circuit operation between the child and the mother. Whereas the bhava, that is external, at the time the child understands the expressions, the bhavas, where the child's sensations, emotions and feelings, all of them are in the developing process, that is known as bhava. This is the first year, it is 1 to 3, and vishaya, from 3 to 7 is known as vishaya. Vishaya parasparya, wherein by they understand three things. One is bhaha, second is bhava, third thing is bhasha. Bha is said to be the radiance of a mother. The shining, radiant affection and zeal of a mother should be understood by the child. A mother should make the child to understand that. That is known as bha. Second thing is bhava. Whatever they feel inside, the child must be able to understand. Third thing is bhasha. So, first stage, bha is understood. Second stage, bhava is understood. In third stage, bha and bhava is understood along with bhasha. Bhasha is shabda, pada, vakya, vastu, vivechana, etc. So this type of special managements are required here. This is known as bodhana. And there are two special bodhanas also. Prabodhana. What is prabodhana? Prabodhana is to create awareness. That is to awaken the child, is known as prabodhana. What are the various other things you have to create that awareness or awakening? Satya Satya Yukta Yukya Bhava Bhava. These three things are known as Prabodhana. How to create Prabodhana with a child? Satya Satya. What is true and what is not? That is Satya Satya Viveka. That is Prabodhana. Second thing is Yukta and Ayukta. Which is appropriate, whether it may be true or not, which is appropriate, which should be selected and for which should be selected for operation, and which is contextually more relevant and applicable. That is Yukta Yukta. Third thing is Bhava Bhava. Means that which can be considered or which cannot be. So which you can consider or you need to consider it now, and which is appropriate to you by this time and which is inappropriate, and what is the thing that is veritable and what is fallacious. So these three things are to be given to the child, and that is known as Prabodhana. What is Udbodhana? Udbodhana is intellectual boosting of the child, by which the child is given valuable concepts of Grahana, Dharana, Milana, Sankalana, Prayoga. Grahana is attention, Dharana is retention or memory, Milana is analytical thought, Sankalana is unification, that is synthesis. What we call thesis, antithesis and synthesis is Sankalana. Prayoga is application. Creating everything inside the child is known as Udbodhana. And Sambodhana is, after the child is developed, you are just communicating with the child, and that communication after the full-fledged development of the child is known as Sambodhana. Sambodhana in English we used to call it as vocative. Just to call somebody is Sambodhana. To address somebody, to designate somebody, or to attend to somebody is Sambodhana. Sambodhana is very casually possible only after this. Avabodhana, we doing things. Bodhana, what to teach them, that should be taught. Prabodhana, creating awareness in the mental ether, and creating intellectual boosting or cognitive ability in the form of Udbodhana, then only a full-fledged, that is a composite or collectively or consummately full-fledged, that particular child is being embraced by us or engrossed by us or being empowered by us, and the whole lineage is taken back to the level of the glory by such a compatible child. That is known as Sambodhana. So these are the various steps. That's why I want to say here, these things are Ananya Sadhya. Ananya Sadhya means unless you have this knowledge, there is no Western community who has ever thought about these things. They consider four things. What is the difference between Eastern and Western science? One is, number one, life formation. Second thing is universal formation. Third thing is human life formation. Number fourth, civilization. First, there must be a universe. Second, there must have been life. And there must be anthroposophy. What is anthroposophy? Anthroposophy is a study about human life or human formation. Anthropology. It may be social or cultural. What is anthropogenetics? How human beings are formed, that is anthropogenetics. How human society has been made, clans, castes and systems, that is social anthropology. How human knowledge has come into existence, that is anthropoepistemology. How human taste and aestheticism they developed, what is the reason for the aesthetic evolution of the human race, that is known as cultural anthropology. This everything is there. So these four points are very much wrongly analyzed by the West. Universal formation, life formation, human race formation and civilization, all these four things are considered by the Western science as accidental. How universe formed, why it formed, it is an accident. Big Bang explosion, why it exploded, it is an accident. So second thing, how life formed. There was one small drop of protoplasm before several millions of years they fell here. They fell inside the substratum by absorbing the hydroatmospheric content. They developed an accidental synthesis of consciousness by which first it started with protozoa, paramecium and amoeba, unicellular organisms. How it happened? Accident. How human beings evolved? They evolved from Homo sapiens. Why they evolved from that? Accident. How civilization came? At once where the person was staying inside the cave, accidentally he rubbed two stones, then he got fire, immediately understood everything. Why he rubbed? Accident. Somebody asked why the world is full of accidents, like nuclear accident, airplane accident, train accident, oil spilling accident, mining explosion accident, vehicle accident, everywhere why there is accident, because it is the output of the theory of accidentalism of the Western concept. See, the problem is they are well structured and well developed in all the areas. Whenever we are going for a primordial analysis, understanding the origination point of everything, they consider it to be accidental or anonymous. Whereas we don't have explanations for all of these various things. Why this is like that, that is like that, which is the best product of this, and that is what is uranium, what is plutonium, how to make this, that thing. We have not bothered with this thing much. We need not bother. And saying that we have bothered itself is an insult to us. But we have bothered about these four questions. We consider everything to be cognitive, incidental, and structured. It is by the will of God, it is by the Satya Sankalpa of the Bhagavan, these four things have come into existence. Creation of the world is by the will of God. And origination of species, they are structured by God. And human being is specially fashioned by God. And civilization is a divine grant. This we can have a lifted shoulders and widened chest everywhere we go to say that we are very different in our own confirmation or conviction in saying that we are having a very strong foundation of four incidents that happened in the world. One is creation, second is life emergence, third is human beings emergence, fourth thing is civilization. The four things we are very strong. Only we have thought about this thing. That is the reason by which these sciences they have emerged. Those people who are saying as accident, they could see only the accidental inhibitors and ingredients. They could not see the causative factors, as they don't bother about the cause at all. If you say something as accident, you will be bothered only about the ingredients inside. Whereas the innate factors, which are the causative basic tools for that, they have not been dealt with them at all. So that is why we are capable of finding out the causative factors. How to bring a child, how to make our own determination. Now they are bringing it otherwise. Now they are bringing it otherwise by means of a new science known as eugenetics. By science they are going to bring a desired child. Desired complexion, desired height, desired weight, desired caliber, desired nose structure, desired optical placement, eye structure. So everything they are making. If you want a child with a grey eye or a grey iris or pupil, if you want somebody who is having a bluish eye like an Irish fellow, you can bring yellowish, bluish, greyish, sparkish, fadish, cell white, anything you can bring. So facial expression, all other biometric signals like tongue style, like nasal projection, like ear structure, whether it is a blended, binded or shuffled one, you can design anything of the choice, eugenetics, but that is going to collapse the society. This eugenetics